Today, I would like to present to you on optimizing N-glycan profiles and their effector functions using a design of experiments approach, which was used to establish the newly released platform that is S-glycan. So introducing to you on the concept of glycosylation. Glycosylation influences the safety and efficacy of biopharmaceuticals, where it is predominantly determined by host cell characteristics and cell culture conditions. Accelerated development timelines warrant rapid and more efficient strategies to optimize glycosylation profiles during upstream process development. Design of experiments, DOE, and statistical analyses can be used to swiftly optimize and predict glycosylation patterns while deepening our comprehension of the process. So we would like to showcase this in two different case studies. They are demonstrated by two distinct cell lines producing two different antibodies using AMBR15. Case study A describes N-glycan optimization of a fusion-derived monoclonal antibody, while case study B describes N-glycan optimization of a monoclonal antibody. DOE parameters were established based on culture process and additives for glycan control. The temperature was adjusted on day 6 and additives for N-glycan modulation were introduced on day 7. Antibodies were purified using protein A affinity chromatography, denatured, and subsequently deglycosylated using the PNGase F enzyme. The liberated N-glycans were labeled using a 2AB labeling kit. Glycan profile analysis for the released glycans was conducted using the Ultra Performance Liquid Chromatography, UPLC. Desirable glycans were analyzed further using JMP software. ADCC, antibody-dependent cell cytotoxicity, and CDC, complement-dependent cytotoxicity, were assessed through a cell-based bioluminescent reporter assay. These results were determined from the dose response curves and by calculating parameters from the 4PL curve. So in conclusion, candidates with no negative impact on relevant parameters, including chemical additives on cell growth, were confirmed. Then those products among DOE conditions were further purified and analyzed for N-glycan modulation. Individual N-glycan peaks were identified prior to N-glycan analysis in advance. All N-glycan results and cell growth, including titer, were further analyzed statistically to find a way to optimize N-glycosylation. These statistical analyses reveal the relationship between parameters and N-glycan profile, hence providing a clear understanding for determining the best possible outcome. Finally, whether the N-glycans could be potential critical quality attributes, potential CQAs, through the influence on effector functions of ADCC and CDC is confirmed. Two levels of relevant glycan sample were used to identify the correlation between glycan and effector function, which was demonstrated to be positive in these case studies. The developmental journey of the antibody therapeutics from gene to IND is often challenged by stringent timelines. These case studies demonstrate that N-glycan profiles and the relevant effector functions of antibodies can be successfully evaluated in a time-effective manner. Alongside process development and clinical material manufacturing using a DOE approach, it is unlikely that additional time beyond the current CDO service schedule, around 11 months, would be necessary, as these analyses can be carried out concurrently with the current CDO service. This approach could offer a clearer understanding of the optimal N-glycan status of your product and potential CQAs during the early development phase. Thank you very much.